thank you through you, Chair. I think the distances that are quoted in the report refer to the nearest part of the site boundary as opposed to the distances to the nearest parts of the buildings and the separation distances that I quoted in my presentation are the ones that have been measured on site and also off the plan.
The response times in the report.
Okay, I mean, the response times, clearly there's this 10 minutes, most of the catchment area is responded to within that time frame. I mean, we heard what the Chief Fire Officer said, and I alluded to it also in my presentation, that despite that target, it is preferable to reduce, and clearly it's common sense, I think, to reduce the amount of time that the fire service can respond to an emergency as much as possible. And the fire service seek to respond to any emergency as far as possible within 5 minutes. So the Chief Officer himself confirmed, and I set it out in my presentation, that the response time in the Upton area would be reduced by up to 1 minute, and not between 1 and 2 minutes, it's up to 1 minute. And response times in the other direction towards West Kirby will be decreased by 2 minutes, which means that the fire service will be able to respond to an emergency closer to their preferred target of 5 minutes in either direction.
Thank you for that clarification. Pat?
Yeah, thank you, Chair. I'll just actually pick up on some of the issues that Matthew's just been referring to. I think it's worthwhile for the committee, particularly when it says on second paragraph, the end of second paragraph of page 53, it says, being satisfied that the 10-minute response time is not considered to be acceptable. And just to clarify, you know, if you look on the website of the Merseyside Fire and Rescue Service and you look at the operation response standards, this is the first sentence. It says, the service's response standard remains amongst the highest in the country. A, we will attend any life risk emergency incident on Merseyside within 10 minutes of being requested. And B, we will aim to achieve this on 90% of occasions. So I think, you know, just to clarify, the existing arrangement, you know, serving West Kirby Horley out of Upton does meet that standard. I think the issue of response times has been raised a lot, quite unsurprisingly, and this is something I really would like to clarify precisely based on, you know, the evidence that's been submitted to officers. Because when you look at what the fire service have submitted, they say that from Saughall Massie to West Kirby station, the West Kirby station area, it is 2 minutes quicker. Okay, so that's what they say in their submission. That is reflected in the officer's report. There is a table that goes with that submission, which I brought with me. And if you look at the actual figures, it's done on an annual basis. They work out the average response times. Obviously, this is done in a modelling sense. They work out the average response times they've done over the last 3 years. If you take the average over all those 3 years, the average reduction in the response time from Saughall Massie to West Kirby is 105 seconds. 105. It's not 2 minutes, it's 105. The average increase in the response times to the Upton fire station area is 62 seconds. Okay, so it's not 1 minute or 2 minutes, or 1 to 2 minutes, it's 62 seconds, that's the average. The net decrease in response times, if you take the 105 minus the 62, you get 43 seconds. Okay, so that is the net change in response times, but that is an unweighted change. It doesn't reflect the fact that there are more call-outs to the Upton fire station area than there are to the West Kirby fire station area. Okay, so I think it's worth, they are the precise figures that were submitted by the fire service. I also want to deal with, at the bottom of page 53, it talks about the demographics, and it says that the, or just to quote it from the two wards in West Kirby, Thurstonstone and Hoylake and Mells, they can identify that there is a greater number of people over the age of 75 compared with the rest of the borough. And I think the key words there are compared with the rest of the borough, because it's true when you compare those two wards with the rest of the borough that there is a greater number of people over the age of 75. But we're not really comparing West Kirby Hoylake with the rest of the borough, we're comparing West Kirby Hoylake with the Upton area. So I referred to the very useful World Compendium of Statistics 2016, which very helpfully gives a breakdown on the estimated resident populations by age group and ward. And it doesn't give it for over 75s, but it was very interesting to look at this because in terms of over 85s, Upton is actually the fourth highest in terms of the number of residents aged over 85. Now, admittedly, Hoylake is higher than Upton, but West Kirby ward is lower than Upton. And if you take the figures for the over 65s, Upton has an estimated population of 3,396, West Kirby has 3,322, Hoylake has 3,186, so Upton is higher than West Kirby Hoylake. So I think Councillor Blakely referred to this in his comments earlier, but the data is very clear. There is no demographic reason to sustain a switch from Upton to Saughall Massie. And I think it's quite wrong for the fire service to claim that there is